Please begin by making yourself comfortable, shifting your weight so that you're feeling well supported, and gently allowing your eyes to close, letting your hands rest comfortably somewhere on your body, on your chest or midriff or abdomen, so you can feel the rise of your body when you breathe in and the way it settles back down when you breathe out. And you're becoming more and more attuned to the feel of your breath moving in and out of your body. Inhaling deeply and slowly, all the way down into your belly if you can. And breathing out fully and completely. Feeling the expansion of your abdomen with each in-breath and the way it subsides with each out-breath. And again, breathing in. And this time, imagining that you're sending the warm energy of your breath to any part of your body that's sore or tense or tight. And releasing the tension with the exhale, so you can feel your breath going to all the tight places, warming and loosening and softening them, and then gathering up the tension and breathing it out, so that more and more you can feel safe and comfortable, relaxed and easy, noticing the cleansing action of your own breath with friendly but detached awareness. And any unwelcome thoughts that come to mind, those too can be sent out with the breath, released with the exhale, so that for just a moment the mind is empty. For just a split second, it is free and clear space, and you're blessed with stillness. And any emotions that you're feeling, those too can be noted and acknowledged and sent out with the breath, so that your emotional self can be still and quiet, like a lake with no ripples. And now, if you would, see if you can imagine a place where you feel safe and peaceful and easy. A place you used to go to, or go to now, or somewhere you've always wanted to be. And it could be by the ocean, or in the woods, in the mountains or desert. It doesn't matter which place you choose, just so that it's a place that feels good and safe and peaceful to you. And allowing the place to become real to you in all its dimensions, looking around you, enjoying the colors, the scenery, looking over to your left and over to your right, and feeling whatever you're sitting against or lying upon, whether it's a carpet of fragrant velvety grass or a nice warm rock in the sun. You might be walking in the woods on a pungent carpet of spicy pine needles, or you could be at the shore with cool, wet sand oozing between your toes and gentle waves lapping at your ankles. And listening to the sounds of the place, the rustling sound of soft wind through the leaves, or the steady rhythm of ocean waves, or the gentle play of a bubbling brook. Just so you're letting your ears become attuned to the beautiful sounds of this place that is so safe and peaceful to you. And smelling its rich fragrance, whether it's the sharp, bracing scent of salt sea air or the sweet heavy fullness of flowers and meadow grass, or the pungent dark green smell of peat moss in the forest. And noticing the feel of the air on your skin as it caresses your face and neck. And it might be crisp and dry, or balmy and wet. So you're just letting your skin enjoy the wonderful presence of this place that is so safe and peaceful to you. And letting its healing magic soak into your skin, infusing muscle and tissue and bone all the way down into each and every cell. So with every in-breath, you're inhaling the nourishing beauty and peacefulness of this place, and releasing discomfort with every out-breath. And as you become more and more attuned to the safety and beauty of this place, feeling thankful and happy to be there, you begin to feel a kind of tingling, a pleasant, energizing something in the air all around you. A sense that something wonderful is about to happen. And you may even smile to yourself, because maybe you haven't had that feeling in a while. But now you know with some certainty that there is magic in this place, and something wonderful is just about to happen. You become aware of a soft presence next to you, very warm and comforting. And maybe this someone or something is familiar, or maybe not, but clearly is radiating love and trust and support. And you somehow know that this visitor knows you in a deep and true way, accepts you as you are, understands where you've been, and carries great comfort and care. And with a look of great tenderness, your guide encourages you to focus your attention on your heart, noticing how it feels all around and through your heart. And maybe you're aware of some tightness around your heart, or a heavy, dull, aching sensation. Or it might feel hard around your heart. Or maybe you can sense deep pockets of sorrow tucked away inside. But whatever you're noticing, you're continuing to breathe deeply and easily, seeing what's there with the neutral eye of a camera. No praise, no blame. And with a nod, your guide gently touches the center of your chest. And you can feel the warmth of it pulsing into your chest. Soft waves of comfort moving into the layers of protection that have wound around your heart, warming and loosening and softening the ropey cords of anger and resentment, wound so tightly that they cramp and constrict the lush power of the heart, walling it off from the nourishment and solace that it needs. Layers and layers of wrapping placed around a wound, a kernel of hurt embedded so deep and walled off so well that inside it remains fresh and new, as sharp and as cruel as the moment it first tore into your heart. And so more and more you can breathe into the warmth of this gentle healing energy, pulsing its rhythm to match the beat of your heart. And you can take in more and more with each breath, letting it softly soak layer by layer into your chest, permeating all around and through the tangled knots and tightened cords, loosening, softening, opening, wending its way toward that seed of still fresh grief. And you might feel some space opening up as you breathe the warm energy deeper and deeper into your heart. And you might even notice some of the loosened cords falling discarded in lazy loops at your feet, released from the work of holding your heart so tightly. Understanding that you can allow this to take as long as it needs to take, because you know that this process must be done with the greatest respect for your own readiness, and only when the time is right to expose the pain that lies beneath, the grief of lost connections and broken ties. And maybe the times will come and go when you can allow yourself to feel the pain, breathing into it and letting it reclaim the open spaces of your heart, giving it the room it needs, and knowing that this is the price of freedom. This is the road back to the richness of connection. Knowing you can do this, that you can breathe into your vulnerable, broken heart, giving grief its due, knowing you are strong enough to just let the pain be an uncontested presence until it is ready to release when the time is right, no sooner, no later. And so it visits you as many times as necessary, each time leaving your heart more open and strong, more filled with the power of its own vast energy. And so more and more you can feel the newly opened spaces as you continue to breathe deeply and fully, feeling the expansion in your chest as warmth and power energize and nourish your heart, as you welcome your wounded self back into your own heart, catching a glimpse of the liberation that comes with kicking off the covers of resentment and dismissing the diversions of blame, able to love yourself, vulnerable and naked, cleansed by grief, rinsed by sorrow, holding steady, knowing that this is the price of admission back into the hugeness of your own heart and into the fullness of your own life. Your companion smiles and with a gesture calls forth a gentle procession of guardians and allies, sweet spirits, magical beings, animal helpers, guardian angels, guides and teachers, powerful ancestors, old and dear friends, some familiar, some not, but all smiling and nodding, gently approaching one by one, come to show their admiration and respect, nod their acknowledgement, affirm your courage, offer a touch on the hand or shoulder, or to bring a gift set before you with gentle hands and smiling eyes. And you understand that these are your witnesses, and they are welcoming you back to your own heart, to the sweetness of connection, laying at your feet the bounty of forgiveness. and you can feel the velvety petals of your heart open like a flower, expanding from its center and filling your chest with its vast warmth and beauty. Aware of all the peaceful power that resides there, and knowing that your heart is your home, the seat of your strength, understanding that the whole world pulses there, in the divine nexus of your heart, where all the delicate luminous strands converge, glistening and glowing in the unseen web that connects us all, one to the other. And suddenly you are certain, you know with your whole being, that you are healing, that you will continue to heal, that your heart has always been whole, that whatever you thought was lost still abides there. Whatever seemed unforgiven is redeemed there. That whatever appeared to be shattered by grief is made whole there. That there is nothing in this world that can't be healed in the vast, nourishing spaces of your own open heart. And so, breathing in the power of this awareness, and breathing out the richness of your gratitude, you can once again become aware of your special place. Although perhaps the colors around you are brighter, the sounds more vivid, the air more intense, and knowing it is yours to call forth whenever you wish, you can once again feel yourself breathing in and breathing out from your belly, aware of your hands and your feet, the support beneath your body, and very gently, with soft eyes, allowing yourself to come back into the room, knowing in a deep place that you are better for this. And so you are.